Not again. Not again.
I don't care what you have to confess. I don't want to hear it.
I'm sorry, Ray. I realize this may not be the best venue nor the most appropriate moment, but it's
something
that
I am working on a big missing persons case. I haven't slept. This is the first chance I've gotten away from my desk in 72 hours, and I am trying to get some food. So can we do this some other time?
I'm disturbing you.
Yes, you are.
I should leave?
Yes, you should.
Oh, Ray.
But you won't.
Well, I'm sorry. It's just that there's a certain matter that I've withheld from you for some time now, and I feel if I don't clear my conscience soon,
Okay, clear.
Well, it appears that there's a situation that I have unwittingly encouraged, and it's taken a turn that I perhaps foolishly had not anticipated or was even aware of as a remote possibility. But insofar as it is a matter of the heart and directly affects someone who is close to both of us...
Fraser, you got from here to my desk. Make it count.
Saturday last, your sister came to my apartment in the middle of the night, dressed in what can only be described as less than requisite attire, and offered herself to me.
Okay, great. Now beat it. My sister?
Yes.
You slept with my sister?
Did she say that?
No, she did not say that. She is my sister. I do not discuss sex with my sister.
So she didn't say...
No.
Oh, well, very well. Forget that I mentioned it.
Hey, Fraser!
Oh, Detective Vecchio, I got another one for you.
Yeah, okay, great. Get a statement.
He'll only talk to you.
All right, bring him up to my desk. I'll be right up. Hey, Benny!
Okay, I'm standing at his door. I drop my coat, I look at him, and he looks at me. You know how a squirrel looks just before you hit him?
Yes, it's just up the stairs, down the hallway.
Would you excuse us?
Sure.
Okay, the way I see it. Okay, the way I see it, you got two options. You can tell me exactly what happened with my kid's sister that night in your apartment, or one of us isn't leaving this closet alive.
You're upset.
That would be correct.
Well, Ray, I had no choice. The door just opened. She was standing there. And then when she took off her coat, there was very much more of her standing there.
Did you sleep with her?
I told you I can't tell you that. It wouldn't be chivalrous. However, if you feel the need to call me out, then I...
Call you out? What is that, some kind of hockey expression?
No. I mean, it has nothing to do with hockey. It has to do with honor, and under the circumstances, I understand it.
Hi.
Hi.
Am I disturbing you?
No,
yes,
no,
you are.
Lieutenant wants to see you.
Don't move.
I won't move.
Can I ask you a personal question? Francesca?
Francesca.
Vecchio.
Vecchio.
To the suits.
FBI.
What the hell are you doing? Those are my files.
Not anymore.
You're out of the case.
Who says?
A couple old friends of yours. All that's needed here is a little cooperation, Lieutenant. Surely your people can manage that.
I've seen your version of cooperation. They're still replacing windows down in Chinatown.
We're not blaming you for Chinatown. Although there are some in Washington who were a little dismayed by the lack of respect your people showed for federal authority. Here's a case in point.
So you guys ran out of things to screw up in Washington.
Detective Vecchio, these gentlemen are here seeking our cooperation on the Madison case.
Howard Madison has asked us to get his daughter back.
Oh, asked you?
He's a defense contractor with a number of influential friends in Washington, the director being one of them.
Come on, it's only been 3 days.
And you have nothing. We're taking over.
Lieutenant, this is a missing persons case, pure and simple. If we turn it over to these bozos...
Bozos?
Oh, excuse me. Agent Bozos.
Call Washington.
No. It won't be necessary. Detective Vecchio, you know the drill.
Oh, come on, Lieutenant.
You'll be kept informed.
What the hell are you looking at?
I'd like to help. I have something about the girl.
Yeah, well, you know what? Why don't you tell it to them?
Please.
Look, get a statement from this guy. Get him the hell out of here.
You see, a chivalric code of behavior dictates a certain amount of restraint on the part of the gentleman, no matter how he may feel, in order to respect the lady's reputation.
And your grandmother taught you this?
Yes.
And you believed her?
Sir, I don't really want to...
Who? You're the one. He's the one in the red coat. You're the one that kidnapped the girl.
What, are you kidding? He's a cop.
Yep, it's hers. Father confirmed it.
Get it analyzed.
There's no sign of him. Come on, let's get out of here.
Sit down. He said you did it, Constable.
That's correct, sir.
He even referred to you as the one in the red coat.
Gee, I wonder why he would say a thing like that. Come on.
I wasn't talking to you. You work downtown, don't you, Constable?
Yes, sir.
You ever spend any time in Haven Hill College, take any night courses?
Oh, this is great. So now you're going after the Mountie?
It's all right, Ray. I'm sorry. I'm afraid I haven't had the pleasure of visiting that campus. However, if you need an account of my activities that night, I'd be happy to furnish you with a detailed itinerary. In the meantime, perhaps this will be of some assistance. I'm not convinced about the ears, but...
This is very good, Constable. Perfect perspective, attention to detail. Apparently, embarrassing senior officials isn't your only talent.
I'm sorry, sir.
Let's be very clear about one thing. This time, you are not going to come in the way of my investigation. In fact, if I so much as catch sight of your little red coattails, I'm going to nail them and you to a wall. Understood?
That seems perfectly clear, sir.
Good.
May I,
leave?
Yes, I may.
You sure you wouldn't prefer a wallet size? So we got a face. What else we got?
Well, judging from the rumpled state of his clothing, I'd say this is a man who lived on the street, and yet he didn't appear to be ill-nourished. So he must be managing to feed himself.
Food stamps, or maybe he's begging food from diners or coffee shops.
And his fingernails. And everything else about him was dirty, except for his fingernails.
You saw that?
Well, he pointed it straight at me, right?
Well, there's something else. There's something on his clothing, something pungent.
Maize powder. Chili.
Chili.
It's the best I can do.
Okay, so we're looking for a transient with clean fingernails who smells like chili.
I'm not sure, but I think it was the look in his eye. You know that long, slow drift from here down? Well, you know, it's so romantic.
I'm telling you, nothing better have happened.
Best chili in town. You come from Midtown, the Lakeshore?
You know, in this business, it's word of mouth that counts.
Oh, yeah, I bet. Fraser?
It's very good. Worcestershire sauce, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it gives it a little oomph.
Thank you kindly.
Sure, I got lots of dishwasher.
You got one about 5'10 short brown hair with a beard?
That'll describe about half of them.
How about this guy?
Sorry.
Hey, what a surprise. Chili. Ready?
Maize powder. Excuse me, you're a chili recipe.
Eat it or toss it.
Garrett.
Get away from me! No. Get away!
There's no need.
Found the locket in the parking lot. Did you find anything else?
Mr. Ford, we've been over this ground.
Thank you, Miss Wilson. Hey.
Just walk me through this, okay? You find the locket in the parking lot. It's lying next to the car. You pick it up.
Yeah.
Sounds reasonable. Were you trying to break in the car, Mr. Garrett? Is that what happened?
No. I told you, I just found it.
Yes. All you wanted to do was return it to its rightful owner. Yeah. How did you know who owned it?
I didn't. It's a police station, right?
Well, you asked to speak to Detective
Vecchio about the Madison case, so you must have known it was hers.
I saw her picture in the paper.
Picture, at least to the media, didn't have a locket in it.
Hey, why didn't you sell it? It's got to be worth something. I mean, you could use the money, right?
I told you I just wanted to help.
You just wanted to help. Can I tell you what I think? Mr. Garrett, I think you came in here today because you wanted to tell the truth. Because your conscience was bothering you. You saw her on her way home from school, didn't you? Purse dangling, gold jewelry, she's gotta have money on her, right? You didn't want to hurt her, you just wanted to rob her.
No.
But she struggled. Things got out of hand. She screamed, so you hit her.
No, that's not the way it happened. She just, no.
Where's the body, Mr.
I Garrett? Object to this line of questioning. There has been no body recovered.
Found a locket. Oh, I did. I found a locket.
That is a lie, all right? Everything you've said here today is a lie.
Mr. Ford, if you have some evidence.
A picture of her in the paper. She wasn't wearing a locket, so you couldn't have known it was hers. And another little detail. You couldn't have picked it up beside her car because she doesn't own one.
Why are you doing this to me? I didn't do it.
Because you're a liar, Mr. Garrett. Mm. You lied to the sergeant at the desk. You lied to Detective Vecchio, you lied about Constable Fraser, and now you're lying to me.
No.
You saw her, you robbed her, and you killed her plain and simple.
No! She was breathing!
When? After you hit her?
In the trunk of the car! She was alive!
What kind of a car?
A little car.
Big car, small car. Was it red?
You don't understand.
Green?
I wasn't there! I just see things!
Yeah. Just like you saw the mountain.
Mr. Ford, that's enough.
He probably helped you put the body in the trunk, right?
No, he buried her.
He buried her. I see a hole in the earth that's falling in. He's saying something.
he's reaching for.
What? What is he reaching for? Her neck? Did you break her neck before you buried her?
No!
Is that how you got this?
No! No! No!
She's alive.
Vecchio.
Yeah!
Out of curiosity, where was the wolf during all this time?
Well, it kind of happened.
Hey, I'm sorry, but my client will answer no further questions.
This will just take a minute.
Yeah, thanks very much, Caroline.
She's alive, isn't she? You saw her.
Yeah.
What else did you see?
Nothing.
You saw me.
Yes.
With her? When you saw me, was the girl there as well?
No. No.
Thank you.
What the hell is that?
He saw her, Ray.
Okay, great. So now all we gotta do is place him at the parking lot.
No, I don't think so. He wasn't there.
You believe that?
If he's guilty, why would he give us the locket? It only serves to incriminate him.
Because he's delusional or he's a liar.
Or because he sees things that we can't see.
All right, you're losing me, Fraser.
There are more things in heaven and earth than have been dreamt of in your philosophy of Horatio.
Yeah.
See, Horatio was
Hamlet's best friend. I know, I saw the movie.
Well, Hamlet sees his father's ghost.
Yeah, he also kills his uncle and spent entirely way too much time talking to skeletons.
Well, I suppose that would follow.
Look, how is this relevant?
Well, it isn't, but it is possible.
He was a crazy person, okay? Elaine, tell him Hamlet was a crazy person.
I can't vouch for Hamlet, but I'd watch out for Rosencrantz and Guildenstern if I were you.
Vecchio, bring the Mountie. This showed up at Howard Madison's office a half an hour ago.
She's been kidnapped.
That's generally what a demand for ransom indicates.
So Garrett's innocent.
The letter was mailed yesterday. Your transient could have written it days ago.
Oh, so then he changes his mind, walks in here, and decides to confess? That's nuts.
Yeah, so is he.
Cut him loose.
What?
Vecchio has a point. Cut him loose.
What about the girl?
Kidnapper is demanding $1 million in cash by 5 p.m. Well, she's dead by morning.
So she is still alive.
For the moment.
No sharpshooters, no guns, no helicopters. We need him alive. We only have one shot at this, people.
What about the armored personnel carrier?
No. Have Madison take his limo to the drop site. Tell him to leave his driver at home. We'll supply one of ours.
If the kidnapper sees a driver, he'll spook.
Tell him to drive himself. Okay. Any questions? Good.
Good plan.
Mm.
Too good.
Mm.
Where's Dieter?
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Five minutes, that's it.
Okay, I owe you one.
You owe me 10.
I know. Thanks.
Thank you. Garrett, tell me about the kidnapping.
He doesn't have to tell you anything.
The FBI have a ransom note.
My client has been exonerated.
No, he's been released. There's a difference.
What are you saying?
I'm saying maybe they'll find somebody at the drop and maybe this will all go away in an hour. But I'm telling you, if something goes wrong, they're going to come looking the latest on somebody and that somebody's going to be him.
Here's the note. We have very little time.
Dark hair. It's a wig, maybe. There's a baseball hat.
Any insignia?
No.
Well, isn't this interesting?
Tell me about the face.
My client has nothing further to say.
Don't lose Garrett. Everyone in position?
Unit 1 ready.
Unit 2 in position.
Unit 3 ready.
Okay, signal Madison. Okay, showtime. Everybody heads up.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, I see it. Okay. Yeah, okay.
What?
Yeah, this is Unit 17. We lost Garrett.
What? Where?
I don't know. Not far from you.
Attention all units. Garrett made his move.
Keep your eyes open.
They're going after the wrong guy.
What's he doing? Son of a bitch, what's underneath this place?
It's in the garage.
The parking garage, all units move out. I want a man at every exit, seal it off, now!
the left. There.
Find an egg roll in Chinatown.
All units in Sector 7.
Away from the swollen sea breeze, the garbage bag trees, the whispers of disease, the acts of enormity, and lower me slowly and sadly in poverty.
South Torrance Avenue, the refinery.
Yes, sir. The kidnapper's name was Jefferson Adam. Date of birth 5/25/49, no fixed address. Yeah, well, it's hard to say, sir. He may have been some kind of disgruntled employee. Apparently, he worked at Madison Systems for
15 years.
years. Plant closed, laid off last year sometime, a couple of misdemeanors. Nothing but petty stuff since then. Nothing that's gonna get us to the girl.
Where's the plan?
Skokie. FBI's already up there. No sign of her.
Where the hell is he?
Oh. It's Garrett. They can't find him.
No, no, sir. I wouldn't call it hopeless. We still have a suspect, an accomplice.
Garrett, correct.
Yes, sir. I'll have him in custody within the hour. A half hour. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good night. Get the Mountie in here.
Mountie?
Get him in here!
Great.
So, Francesca.
Your sister.
You're not gonna tell me, are you?
No, Ray.
I'm gonna have to live with this, aren't I?
Yes.
Stupid, right? I mean, if I want anybody to sleep with my sister, and I'm not encouraging this, I'd want it to be you.
That's very generous of you.
Dead.
Yes.
No, what I see doesn't help people. I feel them. No, I feel them till they crush me. Other people's lives, other people's pain. I don't know whether it's me anymore. I don't know whether it's them. I let them in, and they swallow me until I feel like I'm suffocating. I don't want their pain anymore. I don't care. I just want them to stop.
But they won't.
No, they won't stop. It took me years to cut out the sounds of their voices. I still see them, but I don't hear them anymore. Not for a long time. Not until now.
So why did you let her in?
She's strong. She wants to live.
Help her.
Not my responsibility. If I take you there and she's dead, they'll blame me. They'll say I did it. They'll say I killed her.
You'd be running that risk, but you've been running for a long time, Garrett. They're your visions. You have to look at them and listen to them.
Why?
Because if you don't, a young girl is going to die.
There's no floor, just dirt or sand. But it's inside.
What did you see, a factory, a warehouse?
God.
God?
Great. I could only see part of it through the window. G-O-D, I couldn't be sure.
It's older windows. With safety glass. Industrial. Dirty.
I want ground teams on 5 minute ready. There won't be much time once we find them.
Banker, be careful.
Good listener.
Coach Romeo Tango 09er. We're looking for a green view of Riviera.
Miss Madison!
Ah!
good boy, Diefenbaker.
Miss Madison!
This is it.
Miss Madison!
This whole area is unstable. But the kidnapper must have used something to keep his weight from undermining the sand.
Who's that?
It's the police, Miss Madison. Just sit tight. We'll have you out of there in a minute.
Don't you go away. Please.
No, dog.
Don't leave me. Don't leave me.
Can we drop you somewhere? Great job.
Where's the Mountie?
Come here. You and me gotta talk.
What?
Stay away from him, okay?
Excuse me?
Look, Franny, you heard what I said. Just stay away from him, okay?
Hey, Ray!
Franny, you are in over your head.
Meaning?
Meaning guys like him don't marry girls like you. That's fairy tale. And girls like you get hurt, and guys like him don't even know it, and that's life.
Oh, yeah, you know this.
Why do you do this? You always do this to yourself.
Yeah, I do. You know what your problem is, Ray?
No, Franny, why don't you tell me?
Yeah, I'll tell you. Your problem is that you are so afraid to dream. You are so afraid to reach out for something that you really want. You know what happens to people like you? They get old, they get alone, and they die. And they never know. Well, that's not me.
Hey, 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 come here, come here. Did you sleep with him?
Oh, God. Why? Why? Would it matter to you if I did?
Yes, it would. You're my sister. I care about you.
Hello.
Hi. Well, I'll see you.
Can I walk you home? I mean, your home. I assume that's where you...
That's okay. Some other time.
Map, but you're only going one way. Due south.